The first 10 amendments to the U.S. Constitution, also known as the Bill of Rights, were ratified or passed over 200 years ago. But even though they're a bit, well, old, these first 10 amendments are still the most debated and discussed section of our Constitution today. So can you remember what they are? Let's take a look. The First Amendment is the freedom of speech, press, religion, assembly, and petition. This may be the most revered of the amendments. The First Amendment protects our rights to say and write our opinions, worship how we please, assemble together peacefully, and petition our government if we feel the need. The Second Amendment is the right to bear arms. The original intent of the Second Amendment was to protect colonists from the invading British soldiers, but it now guarantees that you have the right to own a gun to defend yourself and your property. The Third Amendment is called the Quartering Amendment. It was written in response to the British occupation and as a result of the colonists having to house, or quarter, soldiers in their homes during the American Revolution. Because of this amendment, our government can never force us to house soldiers in our home. The Fourth Amendment is the right to search and seizure. The police can't come into our home without a search warrant and take our personal property. Today, many concerns have arisen about our rights to privacy and technology. For example, can the government track your location with your smartphone, or can social media postings such as on Facebook and Twitter be used without a warrant? On to the fifth. It's all about due process. You've probably heard the phrase, "I plead the fifth," in movies or on TV. They're talking about the Fifth Amendment, which says that you don't have to take the witness stand against yourself if you may end up incriminating yourself. Okay, we're halfway done. The Sixth and Seventh Amendments are about how the legal system works. If you're accused of a crime, you have the right to a speedy public trial and an impartial jury. You also have the right to a lawyer and the right to take the stand if you choose. This is important because it will prevent the accused from sitting in prison forever and insists that the prosecution proceed with undue delay. The Seventh says you have the right to a jury trial where 12 impartial peers decide your innocence or guilt in the courtroom as opposed to a judge doing it all alone. The Eighth Amendment prohibits cruel and unusual punishment. Is a death penalty cruel? Is it unusual? It's hard for Americans to agree on the definitions of cruel and unusual. The Ninth and Tenth Amendments are called the Non-Rights Amendments. They say that the rights not listed in the Bill of Rights are retained by the people in the states. You have other rights that are not listed in the Constitution, and the states have the right to make their own policies, like instituting state taxes. So, now you know all 10 amendments. Can you remember them all? If not, remember this. The Bill of Rights are a crucial piece of American history, and though society has undergone many changes these past 200 and some years, the interpretation and application of these amendments are as vital today as they were when they were written.